Hi everyone, it's Galina, and welcome on my YouTube channel. I want to share with you my tutorial how to make this cute Tilda Sweetheart doll with doll kit from Panduro. This tutorial will consist of three parts. All necessary links you can find below in the video description. The doll kit includes all materials except wadding, which you will need about 300 grams. So with this kit you will get cotton fabric for body and clothes, a durable pink brush, buttons, hook and loop strap, elastic, needle, thread, wooden stick, black paint for hair, instruction and of course buttons. Let's start with templates. I'm going to trace all pieces on transparent plastic. You can use vellum or sheet protectors. I like the strong plastic because it keeps its form longer. I'm tracing all elements exactly as shown on template, with ES, the extra seam allowance on body, pleats, sleeves and collars. Don't forget to mark where the openings will be. I folded the fabric in half, so I will cut two elements at once. I'm going to trace all body pieces with water marker. It can be easily removed with water or baby wipe. I will cut all pieces with seam allowance and I'll sew hair to pieces on the least curved side. Here are my two halves of the head. I'm placing pieces right sides facing right side and going to sew around. The neck I will leave opened. I'm cutting small notches on all difficult curved parts, such as neck, fingers and so on. It's very important to get nice straight details. After that, I'll turn and iron all parts. Using a wood stick, I'm filling all parts with wadding. I start with small pieces of wadding and push it into the doll's fingers. In same way, stuff legs and tufts of hair. I'm stuffing big amount of wadding into the head. At first, I'm pushing wadding up to the edges, so I have free space in the middle of the head. And here is a quick tip for you. Fix the wadding with pins. It keeps wadding on its places and keeps a round shape of the head. After that, I am adding wadding into the center of the head until the head is full. Stuff the body, insert the legs and attach them with the pins. I will sew up the opening of the body by hand, attaching the legs. I'll attach the tufts of hair on head and head on the body with pins, and I will sew them by hand. Also, I'll sew the arms on the body. For them to be mobile, the points of attachment should be small but strong. Now we're going to the most important part, creating the hair and eyes. According to the instruction, I measure 11 and 6 cm from the seam on top of the head and place the pins as a point. Then I measure 8 cm and insert pins to mark the eyes. I'm putting small round pins on pins. It helps me to find perfect place for doll's eyes. I'm going to draw the hairline with my water marker. I try to copy the drawing from the instruction. I start from the center point and go up to the little swirl on the right. You can also lightly draw with pencil. On the back of the head, the hair can lightly curve from side to side. According to the instructions, there are a few ways of making the eyes. Take a big ball, a head pin and draw the eyes. Here I have a toothpick with a little ball on it. I'm dipping the head of the pin in the paint and stab eye on the piece of fabric. It looks good, but not perfect. I easily remove paint from bit with a baby wipe. Luckily, I have found in my stash stamps for can baking from Lester's Garda-Tam. One of them is size I needed, about 7 mm in diameter. Place a little amount of paint on the paper. I dip in the stamp in the paint and stamp it on fabric. Also, I use acrylic transparent block to hold my stamp. Now I'm going to try on the head. It's more difficult because head is soft. But I will get perfect circles so I can easily fill it with brush. This paint from Pandora is amazing. It has rich color and good consistency. With doll kit you will get a 50 ml bottle, and it's more enough for one doll. Next, I'm filling the area within the painted outline with paint, including the tufts of hair. Now doll looks so adorable. I'm drying the paint with a heat gun. It has higher temperatures than hair dryer, but you can use hair dryer as well. The heat from the heat gun will harden the fabric. In the middle are two things that you might like. The first takes you to part 2, making the trousers and handband. The second image there on the right shows a video about jacket and medal. If you like this video, please give thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe.